Today's mailbag openings are accompanied by Astra Strong Beer. Very standard beer ingredients. This is brewed by Oxus Brewing Company in Winnipeg. And what I see when I'm pouring isn't what I was thinking of as strong beer. Tastes a little sweet, not what I would call strong, but I'm guessing that strength may make itself shown as I get further into the video. So the first item in says breadboard. And it is just a simple little breadboard. I'm assuming I got it for cheap. I do like to have a stock of these around because I do like to keep circuits that I've built just built up on the breadboard if I want to revisit them in the future. So it's nice to have a few spares. And yes, these are the cheap ones. Yes, they're not NASA standard quality or anything. But for super cheap, I can treat them like they're disposable or consumable, basically. So, yeah.
One piece, new Solderless breadboard, 400 point tie prototype test breadboard PCB. I got this one at auction for 50 cents American or 68 cents Canadian for free shipping. And this is why I can consider them to be consumable. They work well enough, but at this price at auction, if I see them, I pick them up now and again. But because that was an auction, I am going to link you to this search, which finds them. Of course, whenever I link you to a search, I'll try and sort it price plus shipping lowest, because that's how I always search. And as you can see, there's several at auction right now that are in that 50 cents Canadian range, which is even cheaper than what I got.
Next thing in is something that came to my PO box. So as usual, I have no idea what these things are. I don't even know who sent them. On the back, it says pin times one, pin times one. And it is a whole assortment of male pin headers in various different sizes. Though, when you're ordering an assortment of these, there's no reason to order them in the smaller numbers because these long sticks just snap off so easily, as they're designed to do. Still, these are another consumable that is always handy to have plenty of on hand, so thank you to the anonymous donor who sent this in.
As usual, for the stuff that's sent anonymously, I'm going to put a search link down below so you can find these easily. It looks like there was 10 sticks in this package, $1.35 Canadian with free shipping. Super cheap, handy stuff to have around. These colored ones are also handy to have, and I've got a few of those in stock as well. Good when you're wanting to just indicate, you know, where the power pins are, the signal pins or something like that. And it's no extra cost.
Moving right along, we have PC drive. I don't think that's what it is, but you never know. Those look like piezo disc speakers with a little driver board, I think. Ground, VCC, AD0, and D0. And then a little chip and a transistor and a few components and a potentiometer. LM393. That sounds a little bit op-ampish, but I'll have to go and look it up. Well, I mean, we'll look up the listing anyway and find out what it is, that's for sure.
Pzo Sheet Percussion Vibration Shock Sensor Switch Module DC 5 volts. I was close. It's not a Pzo speaker. It's a Pzo vibration sensor. Okay. I guess that makes sense because there's the two outputs there. No description about it whatsoever other than just the title. Okay, it is an op-amp. It is a dual JFET op-amp. Right.
Just following the circuit around on here, looks like only half the op-amp is being used, and one output is going through that potentiometer, through the transistor, turns the LED on, and goes to the D0, so data out, or digital out, which means that will be basically just the op amp acting as a comparator. And the analog out looks like it comes just straight off through that resistor. That diode looks like a clamp, then through that via there and out to the analog output. I'll have to go back and check my notes and see what I was thinking back in May when I ordered these. I can't remember what project I had in mind for them. Next in, again, something that was sent to my PO box. Guys, your generosity is just overwhelming. All it says here is board. So, surprise, surprise, surprise. We have three of these, whatever they are. Ah, these are the reflective mode infrared sensor. Okay, these are commonly used in line tracking robots and things like that, or for presence sensing and whatnot. If something is, you know, close, it will reflect the infrared light back and give you a signal. I was actually just watching a video over the weekend from William Osman, where he had a hackathon type of event where they were making various different types of line following cars, which is exactly what these things tend to be used for. So, cool. I got three more of them to add to my accumulation. Thank you.
And here's the search link with the sorting in place and everything. If you're not getting them at auction, they're about $1.21 Canadian with free shipping, or thereabouts. And the first two or three hits on that are exactly the same as the one that I received here. So there you go.
And the last and largest thing in. This appears to be something that I ordered from a Canadian supplier, so there's not going to be any customs lies on the outside of it. This is a video converter. This is an analog input to HDMI output converter. You can either run at 720p or 1080p. It takes USB power on that side, and that's all there is to it. And it even comes with a small power cable. Excellent. So the reason I ordered this thing is I was doing a bit of cleaning up around here. Yeah, I know, it surprised me too. And I stumbled across a bunch of old VHS tapes from way back when the kids were small and I had a VHS camcorder. And I thought it would be a very good idea to record them to something digital so that I could, you know, keep them in a format we could use. So that is what this is. I already have around here somewhere an HDMI to USB adapter so I can plug it into my computer. And I'll take the old VHS machine, dust it off, and hook it up there and record that stuff for posterity.
Composite AV RCA to HDMI video converter adapter, 720p 1080p upscaler, USB powered. Cost me a whole $10.99 Canadian with free shipping from Vancouver, BC. Though it appears that the price on these things seems to have dropped a little bit since I ordered them a few months ago. Not too much to see down here. It's a fairly simple device. Converts audio-visual to HDMI. It can do PAL or NTSC. Well, that's interesting, and that was kind of unexpected, actually. I figured this was going to be just an NTSC thing, but cool. It upscales to 1080p or 720, depending on how you set the switch on the side of it. Other than that, there's not much more to talk about.
Since I already started prying the top of it off while I was chatting there earlier, I guess we could take a look inside. Looks like there's one main chip doing 90% of the stuff, one smaller one there, and a couple of what I'm going to guess are regulators or rectifiers down there. AMS1117, okay, that is a voltage regulator. It says 12 volts on that one. That one looks like a 3.3 volt. Wait a minute, how is that one regulating 12 volts? There must be a step up in here somewhere. Over here, the chip is a 24C08. That's not one I recognize, but it may just be a prom or something for the main brain here, which is this WS1858E. From Macro Silicon, not a manufacturer I'm all that familiar with. Anyway, that's all that's inside here. Basically, this guy doing most of the stuff, his little helper there, and a couple of power supply chips. Wondering if that is maybe a 1.2 volt regulator instead of a 12. That would make more sense, wouldn't it? Sure. And there we have the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Some interesting things, some a bit more mundane, but all useful nonetheless. I had that breadboard, like I said, that's just for stock, and since I treat those as if they're consumables, plus it was just, you know, 50 cents at auction, so why not? We have these two Piezo vibration buzzer sensor thing, vibration sensor input things. Those are interesting, and I wish I could remember why I ordered them. If you got any interesting projects that use those, let me know. Maybe I'll try one of those, unless I can figure out why I actually ordered them. Got some pin headers as a donation, and also these infrared reflective mode sensors as a donation. Thank you to whoever sent those in. I appreciate the input into my collection or accumulation of parts. And then we have the audio-visual converter. As I mentioned, this is intended to be used just with the old VHS to convert the home movies of the kids to something that you can watch on modern hardware. Well, that was fun. These things are always fun. I do appreciate you guys showing up. I appreciate the donations, of course, and the support from the Patreon members and channel supporters on YouTube. And of course, just the comments from the rest of you guys that are watching all the time. I really do appreciate it. As I said, questions and comments down below. I will talk to you later.